This is a pretty cool update, but first, a big, big thank you to everybody who watched the story, researched, wrote in wanting to help. Less than 12 hours after that story first aired last night, we got in contact with the Wright family. Here's what happened next.
Let me tell you a story. That's how Ralph Hayward's family says he started just about every sentence.
Let me tell you a story. Let me tell you a story. It was never about military, just so you know.
Even though that's the story of how we got to this story.
He's got quite the record, that's for sure.
Someone found the display case with 8 of his military medals in a storage unit sold at auction. We put it on the news.
I was like, huh.
And they recognized it immediately.
When they started talking about it and showed it, and I was like, Uncle Hal, Uncle Ralph? Really, Uncle Ralph?
These are his nieces, and this is Ralph's sister-in-law.
I don't know. I really don't.
She says she's speechless.
I used to do a lot for them. And I guess that's what I feel.
Ralph died 20 years ago, and this part of the family hasn't seen the medals since. They had no idea they were even lost.
No, uh-uh. Nope, but it's now not going to be lost no more. We will keep it in our family.
They have his other memorabilia too, like his service uniforms, his second Purple Heart, and his Bronze Star.
My garage is full of boxes that have a lot of pictures and things like that that we just haven't gone through for all these years.
They say getting this back is a reminder of how important it is to remember.
Uncle Ralph was a special man. He really was.
Yeah, he was.
And to see this is a big honor.
And you can tell just how excited they are to have those back. Now, he spent 22 years in the Army, was very highly decorated for his service, so much so the VFW post here in Denver is now organizing a special ceremony to formally present these newfound medals back to his family. Ashley Michels, Fox 31.
Yeah, so